looking for trouble, you came to the right place. If you're looking for trouble, just look right in my face. I was born standing up and talking back. My daddy was a green-eyed mountain jack because I'm
Detroit superstar Darren Cruikshank here. Episode 4 of Technique Tuesday. We have my assistant, Cody Stamen. The Spartan? The Spartan, Cody Stamen. Today we'll be going over the flying knee, how to do it, and when to do it. So whenever I do a flying technique, I was always taught to lower your level before you go flying through the air. You always want to lower your level. Lower your level, bend your knees, hands stay up, and then you can fly. So, hitting the flying knee, I like to do it off the jab. Jab, lower my level. As I go through the air, my hands stay up, and I always land on my other side. The reason why we land on our other side is because I incorporate the hit. If I don't incorporate the hit, then I hit like a girl. Wrong. Wrong. Right.
And a lot of times that level change will cause people to think that you're going to shoot, and they almost like dip their hips back. So when Darren lowers his level, I lower mine. Boom, and then the knee usually lands.
Wrong way. The appropriate time to throw this flying technique is when they're against the fence or close to the fence. That way it takes away from their ability to move backwards or get out of the way. The wrong time is open mat. If I go open mat, right, I throw my combination, I lower, I'm like, poof, he has the ability to get out of the way. The only time is when they're almost, they can't get away from the cage. So, boom, back him up, lower it level, boom, he can't go anywhere. If you are too far away from the guy and you try a flying knee, a lot of times they just move out of the way, or they have enough time to plant and throw, right? And then and you're flying through the air, he chucks a right hand and you get knocked out. So the idea is to close the distance. If you want to close the distance on a guy that constantly moves backwards, you have to put him close to the wall so he can't go anywhere. Distance is key, right? Before you fly through the air on any type of flying technique, you always want to lower your level. If you watch the video, you watch us, we lower our level and then we go skyrocketing through the air. And when you're going through the air, the idea is to protect yourself as much as possible, because you are stuck in the air in the motion that you're going from once you leave the ground. So you want to keep your hands up at all times. Do not drop your hands when you're flying through the air.